What I eat in this are so overrated. This is gonna be 1 week of coffee. Here we go. I'm gonna do not five fun facts about me, but some maybe fun facts, some less funny facts, but that are kind of interesting to know about me and good to know about me. I'll start with my pet peeves. So one of my pet peeves, when people, like some people, when they take water, they just leave it running. And let me just say this once and for all, and for the people at the back as well. Please don't leave the water running. Just don't do it, okay? I do understand that sometimes sometimes you want it to get cold, and that's fine. You can leave it running for like a few seconds to make it colder, but you know, some people, they just leave it there, and then someone else comes around and starts talking to them, and they're like, oh yeah, and then they start talking to them and the water is running, and I'm like, please, could you please just, I know this is getting very aggressive. I'm just so annoyed with this. Could you, like, please, for those 10 seconds that you have it running, could you please maybe, you know, turn it off for those 10 seconds and then put it, like, turn it on again? And my second pet peeve, let's say class, it was supposed to start at 12, but it starts at like 5 or 10 past, and it starts like itching. I'm like, people, we were supposed to start 10 minutes ago, okay? And often if there's another class like after, it means that you won't get those 10 minutes back. You won't be there 10 minutes more. So those 10 minutes are 10 minutes lost. And you're like, please, please, can we just, if we're supposed to start at a certain time, could we please just start at a certain time, at that time? I'm so, it's just so annoying. Those are like, those are my two biggest pet peeves. I'm a morning person. So let's start with like a few basic facts about me. I'm from Finland. I'm 90 years old. I moved from Finland to Copenhagen in Denmark to study dance. So I study contemporary dance. If you don't know what it is, I don't know if I can recommend Googling it, because the subject is so broad, but I can't explain it either. It's not modern dance, but for people that don't dance, like, modern dance makes more sense.
I made these pumpkin spice banana squares the other day, and they are crazy good. Like, look at them. I don't know if it's zooming in. Yes, no? Literally so soft and so good.
Was the verdict?
Who would you know? Yeah.
What's a good omen?
She likes it too. It's overnight oats with like berries.
What do I value in other people? Or in people in general, like in myself as well, I guess. One of my top three things is communication. Like great communication. Because if you can communicate, it leaves much less space for misunderstandings. Trust. So if you tell someone something, you can trust that it's gonna stay like between you, or at least that it won't like get out to everyone.
I asked my sister what like a fun fact about me is, or like a thing that people wouldn't think about me really, and people, she's delivering you the facts, the really raw stories. She was like, your room is basically always messy. That's true. My room is very often messy. It's a bit embarrassing, but it is, and my closet is even worse. Maybe it's because I have such an organized life, you know. My life is organized, but I need to have balance, so my closet isn't. There are all my clothes together with the skeletons.
And also, like, not judging. I try to not judge people, because I understand that even though I have certain values, and although I am a certain way, everyone else isn't like me, and that is okay. And although I don't agree with something, or if someone does something that I'm a bit surprised about, like, wow, I always try to think that it's fine, like, if they're not like me, and it's fine if I wouldn't do that, but it doesn't mean that it's like something bad. That's also like my general approach to life. I just try to not judge or go like radically to one side or another. Because, yeah, why? No, that's just who I am. On one hand, I really can't wait to get back. It's like a bit less than a week until my studies start again, and I really can't wait to get back. But at the same time, I would just want to have a bit more, like, holidays. Is that normal? I think it's normal.
And it's funny because I have such an inner child, but at the same time, people have told me that my mental age is like 40, that I seem like I'm 40 mentally. So I guess I have two sides. Some days I'm 5 mentally, some days I'm 40.
Yeah, I need to say this as well. Things that I think that isn't too important, but they are perfect, I try to kind of let them go and not take put too much energy into them, just for the sake of my own kind of well-being. But then with other things that I consider very important, it's like very important to me that they are as good as they can get.
As good as they can get.
And that's why some people have the picture of me that I'm really kind of, really let things be as they are, and just kind of let things go and come and go. Then other people feel like I'm a perfectionist. But when it comes to some specific things, I can be a perfectionist, if that makes sense. But I wouldn't describe myself as one. Did that make sense?
Yeah, and in any situation, I try to keep an open mind and an unjudging mind. Because I also feel like I don't like being judged. So why would I judge someone else, put someone else on the spot where they feel like they're judged? I really wouldn't want anyone else to feel that way. And I really try my best to always keep an open mind. That doesn't mean that I can agree to disagree with someone, or that I can argue for my point of view. But usually when it comes to like general life and routines and just individualities in people, I try to not judge, because that's none of my business, right? I'm such a sports junkie, but I'm also like such an adrenaline junkie. Like I love fun fairs, and also we also went to this thing called Flow Park with my sister in Finland, and it's like this park built in the trees where they have like zip lines and kind of other obstacles. And you're like 10 plus meters above the ground. And that's so exciting. And also like fun fairs, like nothing is turning too much or going too fast for me. Literally just bring it on. And I feel like that's also a thing with why, that's one of the reasons why I enjoy like sports so much, because you get that adrenaline kick. Like you feel like you're alive. You literally feel like you're alive, and especially in those situations where you kind of, for example, you know that you're not gonna die, right? But it feels like you're gonna die, and it's just the most kind of, you're kind of scared, but also so thrilled. And it's just, and the adrenaline is pumping in your head, and it's just one of the best feelings in the whole world. Some people are addicted to drugs. I'm addicted to like adrenaline kicks. Cheers. I love it. I also love exploring new places. And it doesn't have to be like another country necessarily, but like just, you know, taking a new way home. I mean, obviously in Copenhagen there's a lot more to see and explore. And yeah, I've gone for the thing where I like walk or bike a new way home. Or just like go somewhere and see where I end up. But I also do it in my own city sometimes. And keep in mind, I've lived there for like 19 years. But now when I went like back to Finland, me and my sister, we went out biking and like we biked to a place, a new way that none of us had biked before. And it's quite interesting because like you kind of know where you are, but it's a new way, and it's really nice and refreshing for the brain. Obviously, you know the city center, so don't go to the city center. Like go somewhere, maybe even like go somewhere in the outskirts of the city where you haven't been before. Like literally find something new. That's really my thing. I really like it. It keeps life interesting, I think. I was also asked what my goals are for like the next years, which is a really interesting question. My goal is to work on myself as well, like as a person. Yeah, and just finding the balance between like working hard, really hard towards your goals, and at the same time taking your mental well-being and like your need to rest into consideration, and finding a balance there. I feel like for me as a dancer, it's a very fine line between like not working enough, working too hard, and then like in the middle, kind of pushing yourself a lot, but at the same time, like not overworking yourself. And I feel like it kind of switches. It goes like this. It's not linear. I feel like I'm in the stage where I have long periods where I work way too hard, and then I crash, and then I have a period where I work hard, but I know that I could work even harder, but I kind of don't have the energy. So in a few years, I'd like to be closer to that fine line of balance, and that's the thing I'm working on. My sister usually says that I have like two moods when it comes to my clothing style. I'm either like full on street, or I'm like full on fancy dressed up, and then sometimes I just mix those two, and I'm this like, I have a name for it, I call it casually fancy. It's way too early. What am I even doing here? What am I even doing here?
So, what do I never leave the house without? I feel like it's an important part of me. So, I'm about to board the plane and fly back to Copenhagen. And for once, I actually have like the tiniest bag with me. This is and should be like the most important of the most important. First and foremost, my phone. It's filming right now. My phone. Headphones, because I basically listen to music wherever I go. I usually have a clip or hair ties, that's a must. My wallet, charger. My scarf is disturbing me. I feel like, yeah, even if I know that I won't need it, I will probably take my phone charger, because I'm one of the you never know people. You never know. What else? Oh, I usually have like a spoon with me. It's low-key because when I go for coffee, I eat the foam. Or if it's an iced coffee, I eat the ice cubes. But I usually have like a spoon with me. This time I don't have a spoon, but I have like a fork and a knife. I basically always have a pen or a pencil with me. And I usually also have some kind of paper. Right now I don't, which makes me feel quite uncomfortable actually, which is cool. Because I feel like you never know when you need it. I feel like I quite often need to write out something. I would say this is the last kind of I always bring this with me thing. Well, except for my keys. Keys as well. Keys. A snack bar or a chocolate bar, because, well, you never know when you get hungry, but also if someone else would need it, or if there would be like a person with diabetes and for some reason don't have anything with themselves. And that's about it. And now I'm gonna go to my gate and I'm gonna fly back to Copenhagen. It was nice chatting to you, but I need to go and grab a coffee, and I have so much to do. School starts tomorrow and I have a bunch of things left on my to-do list. Thank you for watching the video. Hopefully you learned something new about me. If you did, you're welcome to write it down or DM me on Instagram. Thank you for watching the video. Like, subscribe, of course, and I'll see you in the next one.